How's it going, everybody? It's Pride here, and today I am bringing you guys a video as everybody's favorite Dragon Slayer. Well, maybe second favorite Dragon Slayer, but there's a problem. Oh no, it's a bird. I have to dodge it. Well, there's the problem. Using that incredible work of CGI, photorealistic CGI, I would say, I was able to show you guys that this is not viable for me at the moment. I cannot use it because, well, I can't roll. Where am I in percentage in weight? A little bit over 100. Not by much, a little bit. So we're gonna have to get rid of a couple things if we want to be Havel. Similar to what I did with Homeless Smo, we're gonna, I don't know, change a couple things up and we're gonna see what works. But the most important thing is that I'm using the Dragon Tooth. That's all that matters, right? Well, probably not to everybody, but I hate you most of all. All right, so I got rid of the gauntlets and I should be able to roll now. Not enough. Now we just look foolish. We're not Havel. We're a guy using the helmet who's naked. And I present to you the worst fashion souls of all time, Havel the Knot.
More like Havel the Fact.
So clearly we were not able to run the full Havel set. Because at the moment, I just don't have enough respecs, or I don't have any respecs at all. So I'm not able to just go ahead and change. I was under the impression, you know, before I had actually used up all my respecs, that doing back saves on the Xbox One is not possible, and it is. So I was kind of screwed there, and I do have other characters, but eh. The most important part is that I'm going to be using the Dragon Tooth today. Have not used a Dragon Tooth. I used it a little bit in my most recent stream. After somebody suggested it, but it should be fun, man. It's a weapon that I really enjoyed the first time using it. Not a great weapon because, well, it's incredibly slow, but who cares? We're gonna see how we do with it here today. You guys remember when Havel buffed his weapon with human pine resin? Me too. Crystal Magic Goddards. This is gonna be scary. Man, that hits. Well, we did about the same amount of damage to each other. Didn't think it was gonna go all the way behind me. I guess that thing is fucking slow. Damn it. None of those got him. This guy's the king of rolls. We're playing against the king right now. Clear skill is being showcased here, ladies and gentlemen. Take fucking note! Oh, no, 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 no. I should maybe aim that. That seems like it would be better aimed, right? The freaking Goddard's guy's about to kill me. Nope! Not today, cartoon. Not today. Woo! You guys remember when Havel the Rock didn't die? I'm sure most of you guys remember. If you played Dark Souls 1, you remember that very fondly. Not fondly, but it happened over and over. Your death, him just standing over your corpse, and now he's evolved to kill the Metal Lords. Even though it does take up some fucking major stamina, when this thing actually gets to hit you, the damage is pretty crazy. It gets like 800 damage when you get the two hits. So I feel like four hits will kill most people, but you know, it's always the thing. Getting those freaking hits is the hardest part since it's so freaking easy to dodge. Why is he using full Gunders but he has Black Knight Great Axe? Oh man. Both got some good hits there. That's death. GG, man. GG. No quick weapon this time around, so these guys weren't able to just roll. Quick hit. Roll. Quick hit. I know we're gonna get those, though. We're gonna get one sooner or later. I feel like I should go buy some more green blossom. This thing takes up so much stamina, but eh, fuck it. Why the hell did I choose this skirt? Why did I choose a skirt? All right, let's find some pants. Gotta be 69. Oh my god, that's gonna cut the circulation right off of my foot. I don't want that. Not during a fight. Some dookie brown pants. Why not? I did go to the bonfire, by the way, because I wanted to get more people. That was like fucking no one. And it took me like 5 minutes just to summon this one guy. And it's also, you know, got a couple more buffs. So that's nice. He's got the Exile Greatsword, which I think is one of the best weapons in the game. Damn it. He seems to have pretty low physical. You're dead. You are absolutely not dead. Bacon bits. Come on. Didn't catch him. Tried aiming it. It's a little hard to aim this one. Damn it. Oh, I should have used my poise buff, but then if I missed, I would have no stamina. There we go. GG. Imagine how much it hurts to get hit by this thing. I mean, like, in real life, if you got hit by something like this. Tasmaniac. Oh, boy. He's got a really quick build. He's got quick step on, so we're probably gonna end up losing this one, right? Catching up to this guy is gonna be a freaking bitch. Oh, yeah. Come on. He's using that. I'm guessing this guy watched the PvP skills this video, right? Okay. Try to dodge this one. Oh my god, he clearly did dodge it. That doesn't matter to me. You think that matters to me? That doesn't matter to me at all. Your 200 damage chaos bed vestiges, whatever it's called, that stupid giant fireball. I have a dragon's tooth. A dragon ate with this thing. It still has a bit of food left on it. And this guy wants to go up against that? Not a good idea. What does this guy have? The crescent axe. The crescent axe. That's a good weapon. Oh, now he's got a Black Knight great axe. Didn't think he would fall for that. Would going right up to him and using my poise buff be a good idea? I don't know. Because I feel like I still wouldn't come out on top with that one. I throw a couple bombs at him. Scare him a bit. Get him a little bit spooked. Okay, this guy wants to try backstab me or some shit. Whoop, didn't mean to do that. Damn it, there goes my buff. Ah, oh, didn't fall. It didn't hit, I mean. I think he would have still come out on top. Yeah! I was about to say, oh, I should not have hit, but I came out pretty decent on that one. Alright, let's see if we can trick him a couple times. A little bit too short there. Fuck, we keep taking him right out of his attacks. That's pretty fucking awesome. Oh, a little bit too early on that roll, my friend. A little bit too early on that roll. There we go. I knew he was gonna go behind me. GG, man. GG, Hunter. I like this weapon, man. I think it's a freaking solid weapon. At least against some people. There's obviously some people who will counter it like really freaking easily. A quick weapon will counter this thing really, really easily. That's why you gotta mix things up a lot with your buffered attacks and your right trigger attacks. To try to catch people off guard all the time. We will probably get a few repeat players because there's not a lot of people on right now. So we got Bacon Bits again. What was Bacon Bits using again? I don't remember. He's got a bleed build, so this could be very dangerous. What is that? Is that the barbed straight sword? A lot of the panic rolls there. That's good for me, though. Fucking sweet! I kind of staggered him a bit, meaning he rolled a little bit too late. And then he got hit, since it was kind of like a panic roll. GG, Bacon Bits. GG. Man, this thing does some solid damage buffed. I mean, it fucking better, right? It weighs so much, it's so slow. If it did 200 damage per hit, then I'd throw this right into the garbage where it belongs. It'd be right in there with the wooden mallet. Holy shit, this guy scared me. What the fuck, man? This guy legit scared the shit out of me coming into my world. What do you got on you? Is that the Astora Greatsword? Looks like the Astora to me. We both took a lot of fucking damage there. Alright, I'm gonna go right up to him, poise buff, and see if I hit him. No, he wasn't gonna fall for it. Yeah! This guy takes 600 damage per hit because he has no fucking armor at all. And he's also a woman, and they take more damage. Huh! I'm just kidding. They don't. Damn it. That was gonna work. Come on. Just one more. Let's finish things out. Panic rolled. He panic rolled, right? GG, man. GG. Nice little win streak so far with the Dragon Tooth. Didn't think I was gonna go in here and get a little win streak. I'm gonna go back to the bonfire because I am all out of the human pine resin and I want to keep making my weapon a nice purple color because I think it's a very nice color. I do it only for the color, not for the nice damage. If it doesn't go unable, the only person that was there when I came back from the bonfire was the guy that I legit just played. I might as well turn down my volume because I know he's gonna come in here, scare the shit out of me. He didn't get to scare me. I wonder what this guy's trying to do. Maybe he's trying to have like some type of one-shot build because I'm pretty sure he has some type of fucking buff on his body. And he's using an Astora Greatsword, which has an insane counter damage. I think he has the fucking Lloyd's Sword Ring or whatever it's called. I panic roll there. Maybe he's just trying to do ridiculous damage with the rolling attacks because that's what that does. Some fucking redonkulous damage. No rolling attack from him there. Panic roll! No, I didn't get to catch his panic roll. I caught it there. God damn, that's 600 damage. Oh my god, that was fucking nice, dude. That was super nice. Now we're both out. No point to poise buff, right? Oh, shit. He panic rolled. Yes! GG, man. Look at that health. Oh, my God. That health. That guy was doing so much damage with his attacks. He legit almost killed me with three hits. Fuck me, man. The Astora is a fucking scary weapon, man. That's a scary weapon. Just pop on the Leo ring with that thing. Do rolling attacks that are gonna do, on some people, about 800 damage. It can get up that fucking high. And it's unparryable. And it has a lot of range. And it can be buffed. What doesn't that weapon have, honestly? I just noticed that this armor has like a little cage there. You see that? It has like a little cage. What is that for? That's weird. And we got another repeat customer because there's not fucking anyone. All right, let's do it against XX Fury on. What? What? The Lagmeister. Oh shit, I thought that was gonna hit him. Is he gonna try and parry me or something? It looks like he might, right? Wow, I'm surprised he was actually able to pull that hit off, considering he had no freaking, or he was one-handing it. So very little hyper armor. Didn't fall for it. You're dead. You're dead. Oh yeah. GG once again. Fury on. I like this weapon, man. This weapon is fucking awesome. And now we wait. Once again. The stupid sign went away, so might as well go back to the bonfire and get my couple Estus left. And a couple buffs. Why not? Hopefully there's freaking signs when I get back. They're freaking better, bro. Else I'm gonna be mad. Even though the Great Hammers suck, or at least I think they suck, everyone should go use the Dragon Tooth. I think it's a lot of fun, man. And we did get one guy, David Schwimmer. All right, playing against David Schwimmer. Have you guys seen that ad on TV? I don't know if it's exactly like that, but it looks like a fucking trying to be Breaking Bad. I'm pretty sure it's on AMC, maybe. I maybe should have fucking used a poise buff. Alright. There we go. You definitely need to fucking aim that thing, man. Or aim it yourself. You can't let these guys fucking get going. Bad choice, man. Bad choice. GG, David Schwimmer. Props to that guy for using Dancer's Blades. They're very bad swords. I think they might be my worst weapon, like hands down, out of all the weapons that I've ever used. I think I play the worst with those weapons. I don't know why. Mr. QB here, QBX Andro, that I've played against twice already, the guy with no armor. Basically the only person there. It's very early and it's fucking Monday, so this is probably going to be our final game that we play in today's video. I apologize that I couldn't do like the full actual Habbo cosplay. Once I do, I'm probably gonna end up going through my new game plus one of these days, just so I can get some more respecs and have those respecs just ready, you know, so I could do as many builds as I possibly can. God damn that fucking rolling attack, man. I'm dead. My god, I was in between, like I saw him charging up and by the time he started charging up, I was already, on my weapon, so I'm probably gonna end up fucking losing this one. Nope, yeah, I'm dead. Jesus Christ, man. The Astora Greatsword is not something to fuck around against. Seriously, that thing does so much damage. Anyways, GG to that guy. Alright, I'm gonna play one more because I can't end it on a loss. I mean, I can, but, you know, I don't want to. After a very nice win streak, we got a death. A death. But we have, hey, somebody that we haven't played against, so that's good, right? All right, this guy has a buckler. This guy's gonna fucking buckle me. Buckle me to death. God damn, that's so awesome. One fucking bit of stamina. Oh my god, man. That's so awesome, dude. Got very lucky. What happened to my hit? What happened to my hit? Miyazaki, I deserve that hit. How fucking dare you? Got a nice big hit though. If he hits me with one, no, he won't kill me. I was gonna say if he hits me one of those, he might kill me, but he does not have a bleed build, so. Sometimes you gotta use them. Gotta have the bombs, right? Volk Steel. Accept death. He thought he was clever. Dude, Volk Steel thought he was clever. He's like, oh, I'm just going to stand right in front of him, not moving until he hits, and then roll right at the perfect time. Either he ran out of stamina or he mistimed it. So, I got another win, and we can finally end the video. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video with the Dragon Tooth. Like I said, man, one of these days I'm going to get around to doing an actual Havel cosplay, but today it's just going to be Havel the Knot instead of Havel the Rock. I'm creative. Leave any more cosplay suggestions or weapon suggestions that you guys have in the comments, and I'll talk to you guys later. Peace, everybody.